MCP has exploded as one of tech's biggest breakthroughs of 2025, and it's completely transforming how we connect AI to the real world. While everyone's talking about the problem it solves, there's one secret no one's telling you. You can build your own production-ready MCP server in just 10 minutes using BuildShip's visual tools. No coding required. Let's build. Let's start with the basics. What the heck is an MCP? Well, it might be easiest to explain MCP with one of my classically terrible sketches. You guys are so lucky. MCP, which stands for Model Context Protocol. If we break down the acronym, it's model, as in an AI model, context, which for an AI model is its memory, the amount of context it has about a particular thing that it can hold in its memory at any one time. Add into that, that all AI models have a knowledge cutoff, and by default, no access to live data. And then protocol, as in the method of communication. So MCP aims to fundamentally solve one of AI's biggest limitations. That is, its context limitations. By giving it a protocol that helps it deliver more useful and relevant context. And so, back in the olden days of AI, remember we're really only talking about 2 years ago here, MCP evolved out of a desire to give AI models the ability to actually do things, not just talk about. They were stuck saying, I don't have access to real-time data, or I can suggest that, but you'll need to do it yourself. This created a massive gap between AI's potential and what it could actually deliver in the real world. Developers realized this fairly quickly and started calling for AI models that could respond in certain programming languages or syntax. This came about with function calling, but there were some downsides. The biggest being that LLM providers implemented it all slightly differently, which meant that every AI integration required custom one-off solutions. You needed separate connectors for Slack, Gmail, databases, CRMs, a development nightmare that made truly connected AI systems nearly impossible to scale. Things improved a bit with the introduction of tool use, but it wasn't until Anthropic, the developers of Claude, announced MCP, that the ability to connect disparate systems easily really became a reality. MCP has been called the USB of the AI world, and while yes, it's a universal standard that you plug in once and everything just works, in some ways that downplays just how revolutionary MCP is. Almost overnight, every major tech company jumped on board. Microsoft went all in, incorporating MCP into Windows 11, using it as a framework for AI agents to connect with native Windows applications. Google announced MCP adoption across their AI services at Google Next 2025. GitHub, PayPal, Notion, Stripe, and many, many more. All of a sudden, you could take Claude, that previously knew nothing about the potentially thousands of policy documents your organization has spent countless hours developing, but add the Notion MCP to it, and instantly it became an expert. The evolution towards MCP was driven by the recognition AI needed to from being conversational to being actionable, and that required a standardized protocol rather than endless custom implementations. And the numbers speak for themselves. As of right now, there are over 5,000 MCP servers listed in public directories. And that growth is largely because MCP finally solved the integration nightmare that was holding everyone back. What started as Anthropic's solution to connect Claude to external tools has become the universal standard that's making truly connected AI systems possible for the first time. It's one thing to give your favorite LLM access to an MCP server, and that's called being an MCP client. But what if you're the one with the data you want to make easily accessible to an LLM? Well, that's setting up your own MCP server. Think of it like this. The MCP client requests the data and handles all the communication. Meanwhile, the MCP server decides who gets access to what data, enforces security rules, and logs everything that happens. So for builders like us, your MCP server can connect to your database, APIs, file systems, or any other data source, then expose specific pre-approved functions that AI agents can safely use. And as MCP functionality is built into literally everything, and I do mean everything, expect your toaster to come with MCP connectivity in the not too distant future. The MCP server handles all the complexity of connecting, disseminating, and delivering that data. All right, it's time to create our first MCP server. But what does an MCP actually look like in practice? Let's jump over to Claude, and you can see I've already equipped it with custom MCPs. One lets it access my local file system, another can search GitHub, and a third can even query Hugging Face for models. These tools give the AI real-world capabilities. Our mission today is to add a new tool to this list. We're going to create a prompt optimizer. The idea is simple. I want to give the agent a tool that can take my basic prompt and intelligently rewrite it to get better results from another AI model, like Midjourney. So how do we actually build our MCP server? Well, that's where BuildShip Tools comes in. BuildShip lets you create complex backend workflows visually. Now, BuildShip can do a lot, but today, we're focused on its ability to create MCP-ready tools for our AI agents. With BuildShip's visual development platform, I can build this entire MCP server using natural language and drag-and-drop workflows, no coding required. And the best part, it'll be production-ready and MCP-compliant from day one. Let me show you exactly how this works. So I'll just ask BuildShip's inbuilt AI, called Compass, to build a tool that takes a prompt and a usage value. And this tool will output the perfect prompt for that model or platform. Let's see what it comes up with. And just like that, BuildShip has used its own AI to scaffold a complete workflow. It's correctly identified the inputs we'll need, the original prompt, and the target platform, and it's set off a basic structure. This is a great start, but we can make it even smarter. Instead of just a simple logic node, let's bring in a powerhouse for this task, Perplexity AI. For those that don't know, Perplexity sonar models are fantastic because they're connected to the internet and are excellent at reasoning and providing factually grounded answers. This is perfect for researching and creating a highly optimized prompt. Back in our workflow, we'll remove the default optimizer node and drop in the Perplexity AI search node instead. We'll feed our user's prompt directly into it. Now for the magic. In the system instructions, I'm telling Perplexity its exact role. It's a prompt optimization expert. Its job is not to answer the prompt, but to research best practices and refine the user's prompt to get the best possible results. We'll use the Sonar Reasoning Pro model for the highest quality output, and I'll define a clear JSON schema. This forces the AI to return the data in a clean, predictable format, giving us the revised prompt and the rationale behind its changes. Finally, to give this tool memory, we'll set up a session key. If a key is provided, we'll continue the conversation with that key, but if not, we'll generate a new one. This allows our agent to have follow-up conversations with the tool. All right, let's ship it and test it out. Look how easy it is to ship our new MCP server. It's one click and one terminal entry. Then we'll open up Claude and ask it to use our new tool. Claude recognizes the tool, asks for permission, and sends the request to our BuildShip workflow. It correctly identifies the prompt. And look at that. Instead of just a bird in the sky, we get this incredibly rich and detailed prompt, complete with specifics on composition, lighting, and style. Perfectly aligned to the Flux 1.1 and for image generation models in general. It even gives us the thought process behind the optimization. And look at that. It's only been a few minutes. We've gone from a simple idea to a powerful, deployable AI tool that supercharges our agent's capabilities. And there you have it, your first production-ready MCP server in just 10 minutes using BuildShip's visual tools. You just joined the ranks of developers who are building the future of AI integrations without writing a single line of code. Drop a comment below and let us know what you're building. And if this video helped you level up your AI game, drop us a like, hit subscribe, and tap that notification bell. We've got tons more AI workflows, visual development tutorials, and cutting-edge tech breakthroughs coming your way. Until then, let's build.